Hello gamers, I'm Bertuari and welcome back to another episode of Conan Exiles, and today I would like to start to showing a few things to you because things have happened. Okay, let me show you a few other things I have done. You've probably already seen the previous episodes in which I started building this part of the outer defense wall of our stronghold and our keep. I decided to change a few things. What did I do? Well, I added a little door here just in case. Otherwise, I had to run around the whole thing, and I'm going to be continuing the building up in that direction. So if I want to do that, I will have to have a place where I can enter without having to run around. So I finished the walls, the outer side, I have to say. And yeah, I finished the tower as well. I put up a stair going up. I already showed you the little triangular outpost thing is where I put up my arches, and yeah, I've been putting up fences all along the way. Well, fences, no, ceilings, I have to say, all along the way, and doing the same thing here, putting up some arches in those things. I can easily move from one side to the other now. That's also something which is pretty darn nice. So I can run around through the battlements of our stronghold outer defense wall, and I can even head up and head to the top. Now I still have to finish all this. Still need to put up fences here. Still need to finish that part so I can get up there as well. But yeah, you might probably have seen Scriptor's video by now, and he mentioned that maybe it would be a good idea to redo this whole thing as well with the same layout as here. And I have to admit, I have been thinking about that, because now it looks kind of silly. This is tier 2 materials. This thing here is almost tier 3 materials. So yeah, I might change that in the future. I also put up these stairs here. There is something I have to show you. I was unable to put up this triangle here, the one next to the stair. Same here. Unable to do that for some reason. And same thing on the other side. Yeah, that one there. I was unable to put that up. The only way I could fix that was to put in a wall for support, I think, on each side. And once the wall was in, I was able to put up the two little triangles next to the stairs. I've experimented with a few things here for the stairs, but I think from the outside it looks best if the fences go straight up to the stairs. It offers a little bit more protection. So the sun is back up again, so let me continue the little tour around the wall. What I did right here, I did place a stair to get up, and I placed, let me show you, you see a sloped wall in there to close up that gap. I tried putting up a sloped wall in here. It works. But for some reason I didn't quite like the look. Now I did replace it with a fence. And this kind of looks better from below. Look, it looks a little bit more reinforced. I might try to add up a wall so the complete stair is kind of covered from incoming fire maybe. And start the, how is it called, the fences from that point. But for now, I think I'm going to be leaving it like that. I will be putting up some more fences right now. I did have a few on me, I thought. Yes, I do. So let me put that into slot number 3. And then we can close up this gap here. There is something else I want to show you, but maybe I can show you that later on. Close up this gap. Outer face as always. Good, good. Outer face. Good. So, yeah, this closes up nicely. Now I can close up the tower as well. And I have to pay attention here because I noticed earlier that one of them was placing inside out. Just as I say it, it happens, of course. There. Like that. So this one is good. This one is good. This one is good as well. This is the stairs going down. Can I put up? Oh, you see here I did the trick with the walls. Not quite sure if I will leave it like that. I'm hesitating. Oh, the face. Okay. They all seem to be going pretty much out of face. I'm not going to be placing this one yet. Of course, I will have to do the same thing on the inside. But for the time being, that's not really all that important. I will be finishing up the tower. That's something I should be doing. One more. Yes. And yeah. I will have to figure out how I will fix all this. And then I have room to place my archers up here as well. Nice. Archers which can shoot down perfectly. Yeah, this will be good, I think. I wish we had fences, sloped fences, so you could actually put them up on... Right, let me show you right here. So and they follow along the stair, but they don't want to do that. No, I'm kind of hesitating what I'm going to do here. I can't really build out 10 more blocks in that direction. I don't think I have room enough, because this will need to be a little tower, and then we will see what we can do. I think we will have to head in that direction pretty soon. But yeah, we will have to do that later on. No, something I wanted to show you is this. Have a look at this. Here, I can show you right here. Have a look at these. You see? These kind of all line up quite nicely, these lines. They make a circular pattern. And if you compare that to here, yeah, this line is heading that way. This one is heading that way. This is messy. This is messy. Why is this messy? Because I never noticed that you could actually place them a little bit better. And it has all to do with how these thingies line up. Maybe I should show that with some fences, well, with some floors later on. So I'm going to be making some more stuff to build the tower, which will get here, come here. And then I can show you what I mean exactly with that. No, I'm not sure if you guys want to see me build all this crap, because it's constantly the same thing for now. I will be building another section of a tower like that. I will be building that up here. I will record that and add that to the episode. But I think next time I will just speed that up, because it's already the second or the third time you guys see that, and probably not all that interesting. Okay, well, the other stuff is still crafting up. We can start building what's going to be the foundations of our tower. Now, I already showed that a few times. It's pretty easy. It's a shape with in the middle six triangles. Around that, you attach a square foundation to the triangle and fill up the gap with the other triangles. So in my case, I start with a triangle, two squares around it, then two triangles, two squares, two triangles, two squares. Ah, crap. And another square. And fill up the gaps with triangles. There you go. And now I could continue in that direction, but I can also continue in that direction. So I think I will be heading in that direction for about 10 walls. Maybe I should take 9. 9 would be easier to have a window, well, a door frame every other block. Actually, I need 11. 11 would be every 2 blocks. Might be a little bit easier. There. And from here on, there will be another tower. Yep, that should do the trick. So let me think. It will be 3 and then the 2 squares. Of course, I don't have enough materials to do everything, but I kind of knew that already. this should give us at least some room to build in there, I think. The next one will go in that direction. Yeah, that should be good. So from the triangle thing, start with a window. Triangle thing. Yep. That's going to be a window for... Yes, outer face, perfect. All triangles will be windows. Perfect. A window. Actually, it's the squares that are windows. Perfect. Doesn't really matter all that much. Windows, windows. This will be a door so I can get in and out, probably. That might be a door too, so I can get in and out. And this should be walls. Let me check if I have some more door frames. I should have some door frames, actually. Okay, I do have some door frames, so that's nice too. I've actually been thinking of closing that up with door frames and use walls, because I think that would solve my problem with the other thing I had. Yeah. This is pretty close to the altar of Set, but all that stuff has to disappear anyway. Let me actually try that. No, if I place it like that, yes, outer. And this one too. Outer. I think that will solve the problem where I couldn't fit in the slope thingies and I had to fiddle with walls on the top. If I can put up walls everywhere, I shouldn't have any problems at all. So, next up will be the stuff with the stairs, but I don't have the stairs yet, so I will have to go gather some more materials, cook some more stuff, and then I will get back to you guys. Okay, I'm back. I did build some stairs. I don't have enough to do everything, but it should be good enough to start with. So I need a stair starting up. Yeah, there, that's exactly what I needed. Come on, snap. Okay, let me place this one first. Then I was kind of hoping to be able to wait with that. Okay, you see how I'm turning the thing here? It will be difficult to show from this side. But have a look. I press the 2. You see the little spike? The spike on the top corner. It's heading in a certain direction, and that's the direction you will see the lines in the tiles of the floors appear. So I want them to go parallel with the outside wall, which is like this. Yes. And now I should be able to place the stair. Perfect. And you should see that the lines, you see they go parallel with this wall here. Let me show you again from the top. Maybe that's better. Two. Okay. You see, the line is now going on a little angle. So the lines in the tiles of the ceiling will go in the same direction. So they will make a little turn in the direction of the clock. It's pretty difficult to explain, but I might be able to show it later on. So if I want to have them the same way as these are, I would have to do it like this. You see now the little spikes line up perfectly, which will mean that the lines in the tiles of the ceiling will line up perfectly as well. I know it sounds complex, but once you know how it works, it's actually a nice thing to do. And it allows you to have your ceilings all match up perfectly. But anyway, I wanted to have a door in here. There you go. And if now I want my ceiling tile to be in the same direction, I have to make sure that the pointy things are heading in the same direction. It's difficult to see from here. Oh, if I look at the bottom one, I can see it. Yes, that's the way it should be. You see now the tiles line up, the direction of the tiles in the ceiling line up perfectly. And that's exactly what I wanted. Did I bring my walls? Oh, I forgot the walls. I will have to run back. I used walls all along the thing. Yeah, I can do the same thing, actually. Use a wall, which is placing correctly in that direction. This can get closed up. Yeah. And I don't have enough to make the last one. Okay, well, I'll have to fix that later on. So this one is a triangle, and I want my triangle to be up there, so I can place my my stair again, and I want the little spiky things to go parallel to the outside of the wall, which is in this direction. Oh, you have lines on the bottom of these as well. I never noticed that. Okay, stair. And if I have placed it correctly, you see the lines go parallel to the outside wall. Nice. I'll have to close that one up and put up a door up there. But for these, I am using tier 2 materials. Let me check if I still have some. Okay, rest of the tower. We will get there at some point. So, this can be a door. Oh yeah, maybe better to place this thing first. Look, now I can show you perfectly what I mean. You see the little triangle spikes on the corners of the triangle? Now they turn a little bit compared to the ones I already have, which means my lines in the tiles of the ceiling will go in that direction as well. So I have to use the scroll wheel to make them line up perfectly. There you go. And now the lines will be perfectly, how do they call that in English? Perfectly lined up with the other ones. I don't know the word in English. Outer face. I want these inside out. Yes, like that. So this will be a wall where they can shoot down. Perfect. Actually, this whole second floor could be something like that. A wall. Wait a second. So this is a window. I can put up a window up there. 5. I'm going to try it like that. A window just for looks. Which means this will be a window as well, just for looks. And this should be a window as well, but I don't have bricks with me. But that also means that this should be a wall. This should be a window. This should again be a wall. This should be a window. This will be another window. This will be a wall. Window, wall, window. Yeah, perfect. I have 2 more doors. Oh, not this one. 2 more doors which I can pull up there. That's nice too. Yeah, I'm missing a wall there. Okay. Yeah, seems like I will have to go make some more stuff, and I will get back to you guys once I have an update again. Okay, sun is rising, and I did make some more materials, so let's continue our build of this tower. This is outer face, perfect. Now I can fill this up with windows. Turn my windows inside out, just for looks. Yes, outer face. Outer face. That's done. I need 1 more wall. There. This also means I can put up the next triangle. There. And of course my stairs as well. There you go. Quickly check if it's lined up perfectly. Yeah, I'm getting the grips of this. It's starting to work as I hoped. So next layer is all walls, but they can be facing the normal direction again. This one should be a... Oh yeah, let me do that. Like this. It's lining up perfectly. Nice. I think it was like that. Yips. And the rest can be all walls. Yep, but facing the correct way. Perfect. Another triangle. Turn it around until it's parallel to the outside of the wall. Place another stair. Ah, come on, place the stair. Yep. Yep, that's it. That's it. And now we can start with building the top part, the slope thing. But I noticed that I'm missing something up there. Yeah, well, anyway, I will be gathering some more materials because I need a lot of sloped things now. And I will get back to you guys once I have the necessary materials and we can continue building again. Time for some more building, since I think I have all the stuff I need now to finish everything up. I'm here now. I need the squares. I thought the squares should go into the triangles. I'm going to check to be sure how I did it in this tower. I think the squares will go into triangles because you have to try to always put up squares next to triangles. Yeah, you see this is a triangle and it's a squared sloped roof, so that's nice. I can do the same thing on the other side. We'll have to make a little platform here so I can head from one direction into the other. Okay, this should be a... Come on, place it. Yes. And this should be one like that too. Yes. This should be... Yeah, I had it. Yes. Perfect. Oh. Yeah, like that. Like that. And like that. And now I should be able to place these. Yes, perfect. Nice. Good. Amazing. Great. Oh, I like it. I like it. I like it. So, next up, I need one of these. Yes, one like that. Six. That's perfect. And now I need a triangle, not this one, a triangle which lines up correctly with the other one. Yes, that should be a thing. And now I can place my stair. Come on, place it. Almost, yep. Okay, so this is a thing now. This looks nice. I want, of course, the tiles of these ceilings to match up perfectly so they make a little circle. It's not all that difficult, actually. These can go just as they should. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And now I need to fill up with the triangles. Ah, I'm missing a lot of triangles. Darn, I forgot about that. Yeah, look at the spikes. The spikes make a little turn. And it looks actually like this will be perfect. Yes. The rest of the spikes of these should line up with the previous one. So they make a straight line. Yes, perfect. Same here. Yeah, this looks good. The spikes make a little turn, which makes the tiles turn, but I have to line up the rest of the spikes with the first triangle and continue the process all around the tower. And you see everything will be nice and perfect. It took me a while to figure that out, but I noticed in one of the videos from another YouTuber, a YouTuber called John Bain. Check him out if you can. I will put a link in the description of this video as well. I actually noticed it for the first time. It's in his videos. He tried to explain it a few times, but I didn't understand it until I started thinking in terms of the lines of the tiles in the block actually lining up with the direction in which the little spikes go. And that's how I learned it. Now, can I make a few more of these? Oh, yes, I can. Come on. Yes, this lines up perfectly. Now I have to do the same thing in here. Line them up perfectly. Yes. I need a few more. Oh, I hope I'll have enough. I really do. I hope I have one more. Yeah, of course. Of course. Ah, it's typical. Check if I have one more in the box, but I think I don't have any more in my little box here. Well, apparently it didn't take all that long. I had the stuff cooking already, so it should be ready any minute. I'm making the last few blocks. Well, blocks is not really the word. Okay, make it line up perfectly. There. I didn't bring any more. Oh, crap. Yeah. I thought I had a few more of these. Not sure. But we will check in the box. In the box. Yes, I have a few more. Not all that many, but I think I only need 6. Meanwhile, we can also do this. Try to finish or close up these things here. Oh. I think I had it, yes. It's a little bit easier when you do it from the top, actually. Let me show you. So I can place these, number 5, you see. It's a little bit easier from the top. Then you can try to line them up perfectly, which seems to be working now. Nice. Did I do it correctly this time? Because I think I don't have any issues. No, I don't. Everything worked perfectly. Nice. I don't have the problem I had up there where I couldn't place these two here. I couldn't place this one, nor could I place this one. But I think by filling it up with walls from the inside, so this, by making the tower completely full, I fixed that problem too now. Nice. Okay, and a few more finishing touches is these foundations should go up here. How will that work actually? I think it should be like that. Yes, this does look okay. The triangle is easy. Because you have to line up the spikes with the one here. Yes, that's perfect. Line up the spikes. Perfect. And same here. Line up the spikes. And one more. Line up the spikes. And I think I left all that open. Yeah, three blocks open. Yes, perfect. Now I only need to do this. 6. I wonder what will happen if I place it like that. Yeah, still looks okay too. Actually, I don't think it matters all that much with the square ones. Because they all look the same. Yeah. Yeah, it looks the same. It doesn't matter how you turn, they're all square anyway. So, what else do I need? I need probably stairs to get up and down. Oh, I need another ceiling up here. Nice. 6. I could probably close that up with a sloped ceiling, a sloped wall. Yes, that's what I did on the other side too. So I will be placing a sloped wall here to close up this gap and then have my stairs go down here. And that should be the end of the tower, actually. At least, well, if I can get enough materials, I will, of course, put up these fences as well. But I don't think I have enough hardened bricks cooking for those finishing touches. But let me have a look. Okay, it's time to do some finishing touches on the towers. So we will be putting up some fences up here. So we have nice little balconies for our archers. Perfect. I won't have enough of these fences to do everything, but at least you will get the idea. Now, up here, I want to close the gaps. And I did make some stuff for that too. I think I did. Two. Come on, place it up here. But I want the outer face facing in the other direction. No. I actually want the outer face to face inside, so it's the wood on the outside. Nice. Exactly what I wanted. Same thing here, three. The outer face is on the inside, perfect. Which means it will have like a wooden look from the other side. Four to place my stair. Perfect. Same thing on this side. Oh yeah, I don't have my walls here yet, so I can't really do that yet. That will have to wait. That will have to wait. Let me check if I finished it up here. Well, I can't really see it, but it doesn't really matter at all. No, I will be putting up fences. I can't read the outer, so that's nice. Yeah. Yes, and I think one more. Okay, a few more then. Okay, I'm missing stuff, but you get the picture. I still have to finish this side. Put up fences up till here. This one should be open because it will be going down to the other wall again. Then put a fence up here. And yeah, make sure I have archers. Close up the inside too. And I think I will be doing the building of the inside walls off camera. As much as I can, because yeah, this is a repetitive task. I will be doing this over and over again. It will, in the end, it will look a little bit like that. What the heck did I do there? Oh yeah, yeah, I should remove this one and put a fence up there. In the end, it will look a little bit like this all the way around. So this will be the gate, well, the outer wall of our keep or of our stronghold. I think this one will go in that direction, a little bit like that. And I'm seriously thinking about adding another gatehouse somewhere up here. So at least we can get in and out when we come from the old city. And maybe have a few more heading in that direction. We will see. We will see. Now, I think next time also I will be trying to start bringing in all the crafters into the walled garden. And maybe have my crafter... Did I hear something? Oh no. Maybe have my crafter area up here. Little trade area where we have, well, shops, little blacksmith area, a little smelting facility, similar things. I will have that up here. Not quite sure how I will do that, but if you guys have suggestions on that, feel free to post them in the comment section below the video, and I will have a look at them and probably maybe use some of those ideas, because all this will have to go. It's especially the altars will have to go. They are outside the city walls, well, outside the stronghold walls, and we want them on the inside. I will be rearranging a little bit, a few things. I'm thinking about having the blacksmiths in a circle, surrounded by the furnaces and a few cauldrons and similar things. So yeah, it's just a few ideas. I might be trying a few things out in single player to see how it goes. And yeah, then I will be doing the build out here. But I think for today, yeah, I think we're done for today. I think we will be wrapping up today's episode. We've been doing quite a few build, a few, yeah, quite a few English, quite a bit of building today. And yeah, things are starting to shape up to look quite nice as well. Look, let me show you. Look, this is how things look for now. Yeah, it's looking quite nice, actually. I think it's time to wrap up today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button. And if you have comments or suggestions, ideas on builds, things I could try, then by all means, post those in the comment section below the video. Check out the description as well. That's where you'll find links to my social media pages, links to our Patreon page where you can actually support us by giving a donation and maybe joining up on our server as well. And that's also where you'll find links to the other crazy folks and creative misfits guys. And I will make sure to add a link to John Bain's channel as well, because that's where I got the idea to line up my ceilings perfectly. So I will put a link to that as well. Also, while you are there on my page, my YouTube page, feel free to subscribe. Not only do you help me reach my next subscriber goal, but you will also get notified when I post new content to the channel. That being said, I'm gonna be wrapping up today's episode. Until next time, have fun and stay safe. Bye.